Drones, robots, mobile phones, gadgets, and healthcare devices. All these stem from electronic and computer engineering. Hello, I'm Professor Albert Wong of the Department of Electronic and Computer Engineering at HKUST. In this talk, I will briefly introduce to you what EC is all about and what you will learn in this major to start building your future. We live in an ever-changing world. Let me ask you this question. What is engineering and what is electronic and computer engineering? Engineering is the use of science and design principles to create devices, structures, and processes to enhance people's lives. Electronic and computer engineering, or ECE, is the broadest discipline in engineering. ECE uses electromagnetic science and modeling analytic techniques as foundation to design and create smart electronic devices and efficient systems that connect the modern world. We turn human imaginations into reality. Just look around. What do you see? From LED lighting and display, computer touchscreen, your smartphone, drones, and intelligent robots, AI, self-driving cars, to the cloud server farms and global wired and wireless communication networks. Behind our information society are all creations by electronic and computer engineering. Here are two photos of Hong Kong, one taken almost 60 years ago, and the other today. What is the difference? We all see that there are many more buildings today. But the true difference is in how the society is electronically connected and operated today. And we, the EC engineers, change the world and the way we interact with the world. The Hong Kong University of Science and Technology was established 30 years ago. The world-renowned company, DJI, was set up by our EC alumnus Frank Wang. You may not know the name DJI, but I'm sure that you have seen the drones flying in the sky, taking videos. DJI currently occupies 80% of the world's civil drones market, with revenue of almost $4 billion in 2021. This inspiring and encouraging drone story just started off in the dormitory on the HKUST campus. So, what do electronic engineers do? Do we all work on drones? Let's hear from our department head, Professor Andrew Poon.
The works of electronic engineers are very broad, but generally speaking, there are three categories of things that we do. First, we create smart devices, such as transistors, amplifiers, sensors, modulators, which are for the manipulation of optical and electrical signals to transmit information, and so on. We integrate many of these into integrated circuits. Once we have these devices, we can use them to build efficient systems such as smartphones, computers, telecom equipment, and robots. Finally, we connect the world. We give devices and systems the ability to transmit enormous amounts of data, and we build Wi-Fi, 5G, 6G, fiber, satellite, and computer networks so that data, sound, and video can be shared instantly around the world. Why is electronic engineering the broadest discipline in engineering? The reason is that electromagnetic science is the most fundamental science in nature. All modern sensing, computing, and communications are based on electromagnetic science. The modeling and analysis techniques in electronic engineering are also applicable in addressing many problems. As an electronic engineer, you have a world of choices. You may choose to work closely with physical sciences or focus on designing and building circuits and computing systems. You may also work on the more mathematical communication and control theories and AI and data analytics. You may work on hardware or software and things of micro or mega scales. You can also choose to be a hands-on implementer or an abstract thinker and designer.
So, what will you study as an electronic engineering student? You will study the basic science, design principles, and modeling and mathematical analytic techniques so that we can create smart devices and efficient systems to connect the world. In HKUST's electronic engineering program, you will learn the basic math and science, giving you the ability to pursue an engineering career. There are two introductory courses, providing a vertical overview of electronic and communication systems. Afterwards, you will learn the core techniques for modeling and analysis, and for hardware and software design and implementation. Finally, to develop depth, you will choose to focus on one or more of many diverse study areas. Next, let's look at the various study areas one by one.
The first is photonics, where we study physics and manipulation of semiconductor materials to construct sensors, solar panel, LCD, LEDs, OLEDs, flexible displays, and devices for optical communications, which has been giving us an exponentially increasing capacity for global internet. The second area, microelectronics, is devoted to the development of principles, materials, and fabrication processes for creating micro and nanoscale electronic structures or devices used in computation, sensing, and energy conversions. These micro devices can be integrated by the billions into an IC chip.
The third area is integrated circuits and systems. You may have heard the word chips, CPU, GPU, microprocessors, thumb drives. They are the brains and hearts of all smart systems. The core of an iPhone is a so-called system-on-chip with multiple CPUs, GPUs, AI neural networks, and communication processors, all built within one chip. It has more transistors than the population of the world. And this is the reason why a mobile phone is so powerful that you can make phone calls, take pictures, surf the internet, and play video games.
The fourth area is embedded and computing systems. Embedded systems are single circuit board computers with sensing, computing, and communication capability. They control all our modern machineries, from toys to robots, medical equipment, Internet of Things device, airplane, and missiles. Here we focus on system architectures, logic design, and hardware-software integration to provide the most efficient solution in different application scenarios. The fifth area is control and robotic system. I am the leader of HKUST robotics team. I am proud to say that the team has done extremely well in local and global competitions over many years. Today, many manufacturing jobs are done by robots in fully automated assembly lines, and humanoid robots become a reality. We are all familiar with drones. What do we need to build this robot? More importantly, how do we operate them? How can we keep the humanoid robot working without falling? To answer these questions, you need to understand system modeling, analysis, and control. Robots are becoming increasingly intelligent and autonomous. You also need to study how we can give robots the ability to understand vision and language, and to learn.
The sixth area is signal processing, communications, networking, data science, and AI. You all use Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, 4G or 5G mobile, and NFC, for example, the octopus cards every day. There is also the internet with a tremendous optical fiber network backbone that over which this video is streamed to you right now. How can we convey information through radio, electrical, and optical signals? Have you ever wondered how you can send so much information over Wi-Fi and 5G so fast and without errors? Do you know that the rate at which we can transmit data over one strand of optical fiber has been doubling every 20 months for the past 40 years? What protocols or rules and security protection do we need when relaying information around the globe?
Through communication networks, you can collect massive data from around the world. Then you can make intelligent decisions based on the data, and this is what we call data science and artificial intelligence. As you can see, all of our lives are impacted by artificial intelligence on a daily basis. Whether we are using our smartphones, buying products online, AI is impacting our choices in one way or another. In this signal processing, communications, and AI, you will find some of the most impressive and intellectual practical achievements by mankind.
In the 21st century, one of the most important technologies is probably biomedical engineering. This is our seventh study area. If we can build smarter devices and computers, how about we use them to cure disease and strengthen our body? Today, computers can scan X-ray and CT images automatically to spot disease, often better than doctors can. We can analyze and edit genetic makeup of individuals. Soon, we will be able to perform medical diagnostics inexpensively on a tiny microchip. We are also building sensors that are capable of reading our minds. Electronic engineering plays a key role in the biomedical revolution.
The above are the areas of ECE studies. So what kind of jobs can you pursue after you graduate? On the left pie chart, you will find that over 70% of our graduates are employed immediately after graduation, and 16% went for further study, such as a master or a PhD. There are students who will start their own business or may take a gap year. The nature of the job is not restricted only to engineering. From the pie chart on the right, you will find that 40% of the graduates work in the field of engineering, while 20% worked in the IT industry, and some worked in the education sector. In terms of engineering jobs, our graduates can assume such positions as hardware, software, AI, and firmware engineers, or as technical analysts and back-end developers. Our electronic engineering program will give you a world of choices in what to study and how to pursue your interest. It will offer you a world of opportunities. Many subjects in the world today are fast-changing and multidisciplinary. To be good in one field, you have to be good in many others. Electronic engineering will give you the broad-based and flexible training needed to become leaders in addressing the world's new technological and business problems. If you join ECE, besides taking courses, you will have a lot of learning opportunities, ranging from working in projects to engaging in competitions. You may have heard of our HKUST robotic teams. They have been doing very well, both locally and internationally. They have won the championship in Hong Kong for 11 years, and they were the worldwide first runner-up in 2020. You have the chance to join the robotic team and learn and compete with students from all around the world. Our programs are accredited by the Hong Kong Institute of Engineers. Graduates continue to excel in the career and professional training after leaving HKUST. Our ECE students' final year projects are also recognized by the industry and capable of receiving awards. If you're interested in any of the above areas, or if you have any question, please visit our ECE department website. There are free contact points that you can send emails, and we're happy to answer your questions. I hope by now you have a better understanding of electronic and computer engineering. In addition to the traditional study of circuits and communication systems, we also focus on robots and artificial intelligence that cater for the needs of our society. If you're planning to study and develop your career in ECE and to build a better world, I hope that I can see you all soon at the HKUST campus. Thank you.